everybody. Thank you very much for organizing committee, World Congress on Pharmacology, for good opportunity so I can deliver my paper entitled Protective Effect of T-Flavonoids on Oxidative Damage in Peripheral Bloods Derived in the Parallel Progenitor. I am the first author and this is my research team. I am from Faculty of Medicine, Maranatha Christian University, Bandung, Indonesia. A background of my paper, cardiovascular disease based on global disease mortality 2012, that cardiovascular disease is the leading cause of the mortality. We know that's a multifactorial cause of cardiovascular disease. So how can we reduce the factorial risk of cardiovascular disease? Endothelial dysfunction is correlated with coronary artery disease. And then especially circulating endothelial progenitor cells can be repaired, and then when circulating EPC on high number can reduce the coronary artery disease. And endothelial dysfunction can be affected by oxidative stress or damaged by oxidative stress, and then oxidative stress of endothelial dysfunction can be reversed by antioxidant. And we know that green tea, especially T-flavonoids, as a high radical scavenger and high antioxidant activities. How to therapy the CVD, cardiovascular disease? Medication, many kinds of medication. The first angiotensin inhibitors can lower blood pressure, and the antiplatelet drugs can reduce blood clots, and then beta blockers lower heart rate, blood pressure, and using oxygen. And then fourth, calcium channel blockers can relax arteries, lowering blood pressure, reducing strain on the heart. And diuretic can lower blood pressure, nitrates, nitroglycerin can stop chest pain, improve blood supply to the heart, and statin lower cholesterol. And the second therapies by surgeries, coronary artery bypass surgery and minimally invasive heart surgery. And recent have been developed using the cell therapy, especially stem cell. Cell therapy as a promising treatment. Cell therapy capable of differentiating into cardiomyocyte, and cell therapy can be grafting within the damaged microcardium may limit the loss of contractile function. And cell therapy contributing to multiple mechanisms for cardiac repair. Cardiovascular disease, especially blood vessel disorder, and then can be solved by endothelial progenitor cells as clinical application. How to produce the endothelial progenitor cell? The first, how to culture and differentiation of stem cell. And then endothelial progenitor cell can be repaired when the endothelial progenitor cell repair can improve the blood vessel and then cure blood vessel disorder and forming new blood vessel tissue regeneration because endothelial progenitor cell have paracrine factors. This is the stem cell therapy from patient or donor, and then this is how to isolation and cultivation, and then after we got the stem cell and then implant or infuse the patient. What is stem cell? Stem cell is a single cell that can replicate itself and differentiate it to many cell types. Potential of and type of stem cell, source of stem cell, zygote, blastocyte, adult, and organs. And then kind of sort effect the potential, totipotent, pluripotent, or multipotent. It's zygote, have totipotent, but high effect to teratogenic. And then adult stem cell is a multipotent stem cell. The source of adult stem cell, adult tissue, we can get from bone marrow, peripheral blood, adipose tissue, skeletal, muscle, synovium, dental pulp. And embryonal tissue from umbilical cord blood, placenta, decidua, Corypheum villus, Corypheum membrane, amniotic membrane, and amniotic fluids, and Wharton jelly. We know that in the cellular structure, free radical can damage cell structure. How free radical damage cell? Free radical can damage DNA, and then carbohydrate, and then lipid, and then DNA. In the cellular level, the free radical production must be removed, so the imbalance of radical production and antioxidant must be balanced. Intracellular signaling and radical limits. A relation between tea consumption and tea flavonoids can reduce cardiovascular risk, and then reduction in the risk of cardiovascular disease due to flavonoid content in tea. So flavonoid have a high antioxidant activities, but many kind bioactivities of flavonoid in tea, especially tea extract of flavonoid in tea have a high antioxidant, high anti-inflammatory, and anti-aggregation, so can reduce the CVD risk. What the compound of tea, especially flavonoids, epicatechin gallate, epigallocatechin gallate, catechin, and many kinds of flavonoid in tea. And my research be focusing epicatechin gallate, epigallocatechin, gallate, and catechin, only for compounds. The objective of my research, I want to evaluate the epicatechin gallate, epigallocatechin, gallate, and catechin, and untreated cell. We assay four parameter, especially endothelial progenitor apoptosis, proliferation, and then EPC differentiation, and ROS reactive oxygen species level. This is apoptosis on sub-G1, and then proliferation, cell viability, and then EPC differentiation, endothelial progenitor cell differentiation. This is marker CD34, CD133, and EGFR2. Hypothesis of my research, especially this is my second research. Previous, I have done my research, especially effect of green tea extract. And the second, the continuing, my previous research is tea flavonoids protects EPC, endothelial progenitor cell, from oxidative stress through antioxidant protective mechanism, which contribute to protective effect on endothelial progenitor cell. The protective effect of green tea, the first research, and the second research, tea flavonoid on peroxide induced oxidative damage in human EPC. So EPC induced by peroxide. This is how to isolate and cultivate the endothelial progenitor cell. This is how to get the peripheral blood as mononuclear cell source from peripheral blood, and then finally we can get the EPC, endothelial progenitor cell. And then identify cell surface marker for IPC, especially CD34, CD133, and then VEGFR2 using the FACS. And then IPC proliferation. Harvest EPC on D7, culture in serum free medium for 24 hours, and then added by ECG, EGC, EGCG, and catechin, and then incubate for, and then add cell titer, and then measure at 490 nanometer microplate reader and we can know the viability cell. Measurement of intracellular reactive oxygen species. This is a EPC, endothelial cell, and then incubate, and then add ECG, EGC, EGCC, and then measure using FACS. EPC apoptosis, harvest on cell, 7 day 7, and then we measure the apoptotic of EPC. This is a result of my research, that's EPC morphology. This is mononuclear cell, the culture on fast grow, and then EPC appear on 4 and 7 days of culture, as spindle shapes. This is consistent with previous research. This is a research, a result of my research, that is indicate that EPC demonstrating the expression of CD34, CD133, and then VEGFR2. EPC will define as cell positive for both hematopoietic stem cell markers and endothelial marker protein. This is identify function of EPC. This is my research, double staining, adherent cell was stained with RP, binding lectin, and then taking abdil-SCLDL. This is indicate that EPC have a function to taking abdil-SCLDL. This is my result, effective flavonoid on EPC viability. We know that untreated cells, EGCG, ECG, EGC, and catechin, we know that all have viability 100%. And then 12.5 micromolar, more than 90%. And then higher concentration of flavonoids will reduce the viability. So my research, the next step, we use the 12.5 micromolar. The effective flavonoid on EPC marker, we know that EGCG, ECG, EGC, and catechin still or preserve the EPC marker. So T-flavonoids didn't exchange the EPC marker. EPC marker treated using T-flavonoid will not exchange the EPC differentiation. And then protective effective flavonoid on oxidative damage. EPC induced using hydroperoxide, and then this is positive control. The reactive oxygen species level become increased compared with untreated. And then we know that T-flavonoid can reduce, can decrease the ROS level, reactive oxygen species level of free radical level. And then effective flavonoid on EPC by sub-G1 or apoptotic, we know that untreated have apoptotic 11.68, and then EGCG, ECG, or all T-flavonoid can preserve the apoptotic. Conclusion of my research, T-flavonoid, including EGCG, ECG, EGC, and catechin, for T-flavonoid with level concentration 12.5 micromolar was the safe concentration. Higher concentration will decrease the cell viability. And T-flavonoid have a capability to protect EPC from oxidative damage induced by hydroxyperoxide. T-flavonoid are capable to increase the EPC marker, including CD34, CD133, and VEGFR2. T-flavonoids prevent apoptotic preserve the cell cycle. Acknowledgement, the authors gratefully acknowledge financial support from Minister of Research and Technology Republik Indonesia for this grant and incentive research and all my researcher team. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Very interesting talk. Yes, please.
Thank you for your excellent presentation. I saw your slide. Black tea contain more potassium than green tea. Am I right?
Yes.
However, I know up to now, interestingly, green tea more amount contained than black tea, which I can use green tea, black tea.
Okay, thank you very much. Your question about the compound of green tea. Actually, my research I have not done to isolate because I can get this is not my background. I am not organic chemistry background. So I am from Faculty of Medicine. So I can get and I can buy the pure compounds, many kind compounds from tea, especially for flavonoids, ethyl catechin, catechin, and I use for compound. So I didn't isolation by myself, so I can get.
Good.